Annyeong haseyo and welcome. Hello. We're back here in Changwon. What a great shot of the finals hall you're seeing on your screens at the moment as we begin the next final of day nine. This is the 25-meter rapid-fire pistol men's final, one of my favorites of the entire championships. And joining me in the commentary position this afternoon is Christian Callahan of GB Shooting. Hello.
Annyeonghaseyo.
You've been practicing like me.
A little bit, yeah.
So we're about to get underway with this final. I mean, to say this is a world-class lineup is an understatement. I mean, you'd expect that, of course, with a world championship final such as this, but there's some real quality here. We've got the world number one. We've also got the world record holder as well. If you were here back in April for the World Cup here at Changwon in Korea, Kim Jong-hong of Korea hit a world record of 48. I mean, it's just incredible to think that he's taken all of those shots and only missed twice.
Yeah, yeah, there really is no room for error, you know, with that level of shooting. And it's going to be, you know, interesting to see if they can do the same again today or get close or maybe even beat it.
It would be, I mean, it'd be amazing to see even the world record equaled, if not overtaken for today. But there's some real quality in this final, which we'll do the introductions for in just a second. But this is day nine, and this is ISSF TV, and wherever you're watching around the world, you are very welcome. It's just coming up to 2:30 local time here in Changwon in the Republic of Korea. So the Chief Range Officer, Mr. Park Kirim, has asked the athletes to lay down their weapons. Pistols, really, shall I say, rather than calling it. It's not a weapon, of course. It's an air pistol.
World Championships and the International Shooting Sport Federation.
So the introductions are just taking place now. Shaq Sia of Great Britain is the announcer for this afternoon.
And this is the final for the men's 25-meter rapid-fire pistol. The six athletes are in position, and this is how they line up.
So here we go then, on firing point A, representing the Russian Federation, Alexei Klimov, now 43 years old, but what a medal cabinet he has. A world championship gold from Munich 2010. He also has three World Cup final gold medals and six World Cup medals, plus two European championship medals. They're just the golds, by the way. There are plenty of silver and bronzes too. Here's the world number one then. This is Lin Junmin of the People's Republic of China, 21 years old. Gold medalist in the World Cup in Munich earlier this year, and also in Fort Benning, those two World Cups back to back with two golds. Also took a silver medal in Jakarta, the Asian Games. That was literally just a few weeks ago, so fresh to this tournament from Jakarta. Now here's a guy who seems to have been around forever, but he's still only 22. The world number five representing France, Jean Quiconpois, there he is. One of the tallest shooters in the business as well.
On firing point D,
he has a world championship gold as a junior in 2014 and the silver medalist at the Rio Olympics. Here's Oliver Geis of Germany.
Oliver Geis.
The world number four. So it's the world number four and the world number five next to each other on this lineup. Oliver Geis, the silver medalist from the World Championships. 4 years ago, that was in Granada. He also has a World Cup gold from 2015 in Fort Benning. Plus many silvers and bronzes. Again, the amount of medals throughout collectively for these athletes this afternoon is just incredible. You'd literally need a truckload. Again, representing the People's Republic of China, Zhang Zheng, 33 years old, World Championship silver 8 years ago in Munich, 2010, and he's at his third World Championships.
And he won gold in Granada.
And here is the world record holder, Kim Junhong, the defending world champion, gold medal in Granada 4 years ago. And gold here in Changwon in the World Cup. If you were here to witness that in April, it was incredible. The world record of 48. There's Susan Abbott of the United States of America. She's our jury member in charge of this final. And Park Kirim of the Republic of Korea. There he is again, who has been commanding Ladies with such authority and grace as well. He's a very, very gentle and nice man. And he's been looking after all of the pistol finals for this World Championship so far. So there's how they line up then. Klimov of Russia on firing point A. It's Lin of China on B. Ki Kompois of France on firing point C. Geis of Germany on D. Zhang of China on E. And we have Kim of the Republic of Korea on firing point F. So, Christian, do you think you could make a call on this one?
Yeah, I could make one. Would it be a silly thing to do? Definitely. Yeah, I mean, we've got, as you said yourself, so many medalists from World Cups, previous world champions, world record holders, everything.
Personally, I think this is the most contested final we've had so far.
Yeah.
On paper.
Yeah, definitely.
Based on medals, world ranking, a mixture of the world number one, world record holder, world number four, world number five.
Yeah.
The medals these guys have got. I mean, we've got an Olympic silver medalist from Rio.
Yep. Yep.
There's World Cup gold medalists. I mean, again, Klimov of Russia. You'd be there all day counting his his medals.
Yeah. No, I mean, it's an incredible lineup. And speaking of world records, actually in the team event for this discipline, China set a new world record. They beat their own one from 8 years ago in Munich. But also Germany, who came second in the team event, broke the world record as well. But of course, they don't get the new title because China beat it by even more than that. I think that's pretty remarkable effort and just shows that the qualification scores are really, you know, pretty high. 5.84, 19 X's to make the final. The standard's high, as you would hope and expect.
It is, yes.
Attention.
And the world record holder, 38 shots. Will it be equaled? Will it be eclipsed today? I mean, it's an amazing world record. I mean, as world records are, that's why they're called world records. But we're underway then. Klimov of Russia opens with four hits.
Klimov had quite a tough time getting to this final because in the second stage of the qualification earlier today, they had some problems with the targets, and himself and Swiss shooter Sandro had to reshoot their entire second half on their own after everybody else had finished. So to still pull out a good performance and make the final is you know, good effort under those conditions.
Attention.
Watch how fast this guy does his raise. I was watching him in the qualification and it just comes straight up.
Four hits. Two athletes, both with four. So here he goes then, one of the tallest athletes we have in world shooting. This is Jean Ki Kompois of France.
And another very unique raise onto the first target.
Attention!
There's something about him as well that it's amazing to think he is only 22, because to me, he doesn't necessarily look old at that, but I think it's the way he handles himself. He just he looks like he's been around for years.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. It's
it's upsetting. Composure and confidence there, isn't there?
I mean, yeah.
It's almost like, I've been shooting for 15 years, and you know, rather than you know, on the world level, five.
Yeah, yeah, it's absolutely remarkable.
So Oliver Geis of Germany opens up with a four. We still don't have all five just yet. There's an example of what Christian and I are looking at as well, and what the audience can see.
Done.
There are two large screens above the shooters, and then there are also two large LEDs amongst the crowd as well. So that's the other great thing about this finals hall, which we've been talking about all week. I think not only do the athletes love it, I think the spectators do too. We're so well served here by the Koreans. We really have been looked after and spoilt, really, with the quality of conditions that we've got here in Changwon. Now, only two for Zhang
He was not impressed. The expression on his face at the end of that series.
Kim.
So here goes Kim then, the world record holder. Here he is.
Attention.
Looked for a minute there like he was going to fire one up to the camera, but...
Probably still get the world record.
Three hits. So, first series is down. And not one athlete yet with a perfect five.
And as you can see,
so this first time you've seen a final such as this, there will be eight series of five shots. The eliminations start after shot 20. Where sixth will be eliminated, then fifth, fourth, and then we don't go down to the medal stages. There are quota places at stake as well for this final. This is all in line with Tokyo 2012. 2020 even. It was London 2012.
2012 was good.
Yeah, 2012 was good. That was London. 2020. There are four. Thank you, Chrissy. There are four quota places available to the top six who finish in this final. So only four of the six. So even without a medal, perhaps you are awarded a quota place. It doesn't necessarily guarantee your plane ticket to Tokyo, but it's a good start.
Well, that world record is looking pretty safe at the moment. Only two shooters three shooters can do it still. Imagine what Kim is thinking now. In one series, I've dropped the same number of points that I dropped in an entire final last time I was here. Where's the door? I'll go home now.
Can you imagine if it just was one series?
Oh, painful.
Just five shots. There we go. The crowd are loving this.
Lin.
The first perfect five for Lin of China. Klimov, by the way, of Russia, opened up with three hits. So he's now on a total of seven, and Lin of China now on nine, so leading the competition, but obviously there's still the other shooters to go. Here he is again then, Jean-Ki Compois of France.
Attention.
Just the way his whole upper body just drops down and then comes back up.
His breathing as well, you really... He's got a very clear and set routine, and as a spectator, it's easy to pick some of it out. Some shooters, it's very difficult to see what they're doing in their preparation. But Jean, there, he's a real example of how some of these shooters prepare when they come to take their shots.
We'll see the complete opposite with Geis here, because his whole body will stay still and just the shoulder goes down. Everything else stays absolutely still. And bam, just a shoulder. It looks smooth.
One
hit.
That's unfortunate.
Oliver Geis will not be happy with that.
Done.
That one hit, I think, was at a 9.8, I can see over there. So it was only just a hit at that.
Attention!
Yeah. As Christian's pointed out, you do need to hit a 9.7. So there we go, there are five 9.7s or higher just there for Zhang of China. It's now only the two Chinese athletes who have scored perfect fives. Now, Kim, in order to equal his world record, now needs to hit every single target for the remainder of the final. It's not going to happen for him today.
Over time as well.
And he's exceeded the 4 seconds.
to just...
out of time. So one hit deduction. Result.
So he has a hit deducted. So Kim only scored two because of exceeding the 4 seconds. And that's two series down. So here's how it's looking then. Lin of China leads on nine hits. We have Klimov and Zhang both on seven. Ki Kompwa of France on six. And then Guys of Germany and Kim of Korea share five hits. This is not going how I thought it would, Christian.
No, definitely not. We're not seeing a textbook example of here's how to make a final world record.
Yeah, this is nerves, perhaps?
Yeah, it could be. It could be.
Because all six of these, I mean, the quality amongst these six shooters is just incredible. Yeah. And
attention.
I can only think that it's just the occasion that's perhaps causing some faltering here.
See, that looked okay from here. Couldn't see any obvious mistakes. But.
An 8.9.
Which is interesting, because it's, for none of them, it's the first time they've done something at this level, is it? You know, so it's not like, you know, what's going on?
Exactly. This isn't 16-year-olds in a junior final who, you know, might be shaking at the knees. These are guys
attention.
Who...
Well, half of them are 16 or almost. But well, yeah,
these
still got
days,
World Cup medals.
Yeah.
Straight up. Oh. Oh, no. Absolute nightmare.
Two hit.
I'd say that was a lucky two hits as well, maybe.
Yeah,
that was
I think so, Christian. I mean, this is causing a real buzz amongst the crowd. I mean, I think people are almost perhaps saying the same thing we are. They're like, what's going on? What's
that
happening here?
Oh, dear. Is that Ollie guys laughing down there we can see?
I mean, is this the funfair? The sights off?
Send in the clowns.
Yeah.
Attention.
You know, obviously, you don't win a teddy bear at the end of this, but... Again, two.
Two hits, what's that?
I think Ki Kompwa there shakes his head. He can't believe it.
Guys.
This is really something, isn't it? I mean, you would not expect to see many people getting below three hits at an event like this. And at the moment, I can only see, one, four, five maybe that have got above that. You know?
Attention.
I think this is the first time we've had a final as well, Christian, where... the crowd are clearly already talking amongst themselves so early in the final. But this is only the third series.
Guys, three hits.
Okay,
three hits for Oliver Guys of Germany.
10.9 on his middle target there.
Down.
But sadly, you don't get an extra hit for that, which is a shame.
Yeah, this is it. I mean, you could hit 9.7s the whole way through the final, and the other athlete can hit 10.9s the whole way through the final. But
the same result, but in the qualification, that's the difference between a 45 and a 50, which is a massive
Precisely. Yeah, exactly. Oh, there we go, then. Upping the game is Zhang of China. It's the two Chinese athletes who lead at the moment.
Kim.
We've still got Kim of Korea to shoot, however.
What I thought was really interesting the last time we saw Kim do a series was where his eyes were looking. So when he brings the gun down before the series, his eyes look at about three or four different spots as they come back up towards the target.
Attention.
And I always think that's really interesting to see. We're not going to see the front, are we? No, you can't see his eyes this time. But always really interesting to see where the athletes are looking because everybody does it differently. Yes.
I mean, I noticed Guy's as well. His eyes are all over the place, for want of a better term.
After the third series, this is looking very, very good for China at the moment because they occupy the
so
two positions.
I'm a bit gobsmacked, really, but here's how it's looking after three series. We have Zhang of China on 12. We have Lin of China on 11. Oliver Geis shares 8 hits with Kim of Korea and also Klimov of Russia and Ki Kwon Pua. So we have 4 athletes tied on 8 hits with the 2 Chinese athletes leading the way with only 1 hit separating them. 12 is the total at the moment.
I know what it is now. It's because we were talking about that world record so much before the final. Complete commentator's curse. Nobody can do it now. It's going to stand forever.
Yeah, they're not ear defenders. They must be headphones listening to us.
What else would you listen to, let's be honest? You know?
So here's Klimov of Russia, the eldest athlete in this final. 43 years old now, and here we go. I think we're starting to get a final on our hands here,
yeah,
Christian.
There we go.
5 hits. Brilliant.
Lin.
Maybe this is the favourite song on the ISSF playlist that's come up now. This is a good playlist they've got here, don't you think? It's a lot of K-pop. I'm enjoying it.
Attention.
Yeah, it's all part of the modern arena now of shooting with announcers and music playing in the background and sense of atmosphere that's not just connected with the shooting. Here we go, another straight 5. So Lin responds to Klimov's 5, doing exactly the same thing. If you can do it, so can I.
It was interesting to see his eyes there. It was the same as Kim, I think, in coming up the different stages, you know, from the sights up to the target before he raised the gun.
Attention!
Ki Kwon Pua, France, scores 4. Let's see what Geis of Germany now can come up with. He knows that the standard has been raised in this series. What can he do?
Attention.
Four hits.
Almost textbook.
This is more of what I expected to see, Christian.
Absolutely, absolutely. You know,
a 5, a 5, a 4, and a 4.
Yep.
Two athletes to go.
His timing there, Ollie's timing in that series, was really, you got a quick first target off and then it was slow to the rest of the targets. Everything was controlled in the rhythm. Nothing was, you know, a rush. There was no wobbles, no hesitation. Everything was by the book, which is what you need, really.
Three hits from Zhang of China. That's the lowest so far in this series.
Kim.
But he's still in second position. Even if Kim hits all 5 here, he can only go as high as 3rd.
Attention.
Watch his eyes. So the no. Oh, three-way shoot-off.
Here we go. This is getting exciting now. So there we go. 4 series in, 20 shots so far in this final, and we have a 3-way shoot-off. Geis of Germany, Kim of Korea, and Ki Kwon Pua of France, all on a total of 12.
I see eight hits dropped already by new 4 series in. It's a lot of lost points today.
Attention.
But I think to even see this now, a 3-way shoot-off shows that they've all been struggling today.
Absolutely.
Pecan-poire with two. Might not be enough, but with the way this final's been going, Christian, who knows? Here's Guys of Germany. I think he's talking to himself, takes a deep breath. This is when experience Attention. And class kicks in at a time like this. A World Championships, a shoot-off after the fourth series. And three for Oliver Guy. So it's actually three for Jean-Ki Compois as well. I stand corrected. I think I said two.
What do you think? Is he going to get three?
I was going to say, Christian, I think, you know, is this going to go to...
Why not?
One of the most intriguing finals I think I've ever witnessed. Let's see what happens here. Here's the world record holder. This is Kim.
Put his eyes to the eyes. They're all the way down. They're a little bit more. All the way. There we are. What's that? Come on, three. Come on.
Two. So two hits, it means that Kim Jong-hong, the world record holder, will be leaving this final in sixth position. I mean, there's almost a stunned silence across the crowd here, although the home nation and the supporters from Korea go bananas anyway for their shooter. He's now eliminated from this final. Guys and Ki Compois survive. And surviving a shoot-off on three, Christian.
Yeah, you wouldn't expect to get away with that, you know.
I mean, this sort of thing, you know, if you and I were chatting about this, you know, over lunch, and I was saying things to you like, World Championships, you know, you only have to hit two or three per series. And
get out of here.
Yeah, if you go to a shoot-off, you know, three, we'll see you through. I mean, you would laugh me out of the building.
Yeah, absolutely.
Attention.
I feel a bit sorry for the audience because we've got a lot of you know, local Korean people coming here to support the support their own team, and sadly he's out already.
This is Klimov of Russia with a four. Brings his total to 17 hits.
Lin.
Here goes Lin of China.
Attention.
And then that pistol is going to be raised.
Like lightning.
Literally whipped up. There it is.
Lin.
Four. Takes his total to 20. So he's three in front of Klimov at the moment with Zhang of China, Geis and Ki Compois now. Still to shoot. Oliver Geis can't even look.
Attention!
Perhaps going into some mental meditation. He's certainly up to something.
I think it's... Well,
the French are loving that.
I think Mr. Geister is trying to make sure he doesn't get any casings in his eyes.
Yeah.
Quick one, poor shoots.
C'est magnifique, as they would say in France. Five hits. Ki Compois. Here's Guys, who's been talking to himself and getting himself in the zone. Just needs to make sure he's in the 9.7 zone or higher.
Ooh, timing.
And again, you could tell. You could tell. You could almost count. I thought that sounded late.
Yeah.
And it was.
He just slowed down halfway, didn't he?
He did. Just on that.
Oh no.
Fourth and fifth shot there, so he gets nothing.
And he's already putting his safety flag in. He already knows he's out. But most importantly, he knows he's not going to get a quota place. Because now we know two Chinese, a French and a Russian for the quotas, by the looks.
Yeah, disappointing day for the world number four, Oliver Geis.
Can see his coach, Detlef Glenn's down there shaking his head and curling up in his chair.
Yeah, that's deep left Glenn's, the German coach, who always wears that orange cap. He's always spot him from a mile off.
Done. Five hit.
The Chinese are starting to run away with this. Zhang of China scores a straight five. That means he's tied with his fellow countrymen. Him and Lin are on 20 hits. Klimov of Russia on 17. Ki Kompoi tied on 17 also. But it's Oliver Geis of Germany who, as Christian pointed out, had already put his safety flag back into his pistol. Takes his seat there next to his coach, Detlef Glenz of Germany. And once again, it's the and for Oliver Geis, he literally leaves, well, 3 points behind, not exactly empty-handed. He's got his pistol, of course, but he's got no quota place now, and no medal.
We can confirm at this stage that China
and I think he's just talking it through there with his coach, trying to explain perhaps what happened or how
so
he felt.
Very well done
and
to them. And ladies and gentlemen,
that's tough. But yeah, that, you know, at the same time, that's shooting.
Absolutely.
Christian, this
it
is.
It seems like there is some section of the audience deliberately being quiet when one shooter shoots and then being loud for the rest of them. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a fair competition, please. You either support all of the athletes.
I think there's a message just going around the athletes
so
at the moment over crowd noise.
Thank you for your understanding.
Perhaps indicating that some shooters are having more noise created for them. I don't know, as a distraction or encouragement. I don't quite know, but
could be either. In the Bundesliga, it might be as a distraction, but at the Commonwealth Games earlier this year, it was definitely support for the local athletes there.
Attention.
So three for Klimov of Russia.
Lin.
I'm not sure he's in a position to be getting away with three hits.
Yeah, because if Ki Kompoi scores at least three, then they're going to a shoot-off. And
attention.
Zhang and Lin.
It's the same thing with his eyes then.
Yeah, that sounded to me like all five.
Yep.
and it looked like it too. So for the second series in a row, Lin scores a straight five.
Kikampur.
Sorry, beg your pardon. It was four last time. It was five the series before that. But still, that's a 14 total over the last three series. That's more like it. Here goes Kikampur then. He's literally shooting to stay in this final. He needs at least three to take it to a shoot-off. Four, and he's safe. Look at the determination on his voice, on his face.
There we are. That's
French
his answer.
Support, I mean, including Hamish McInnes and McInnes and also Peter Underhill of Great Britain, even in mixed in with the French team there. And Ki Kompoi with the five.
Attention.
There's nothing more you can ask for, really.
He looks very calm and relaxed, doesn't he? It's another day at the office.
Almost down. Like it's routine. There's four
sure
hits for Zhang of China.
Ladies and gentlemen, we do have the
so,
next elimination.
Like we were saying earlier on, Klimov with a score of three. We didn't think it would be enough on this particular series, and that's exactly what's happened. So leaving this competition, but with a quota place for Tokyo 2020.
That'll definitely soften the blow of no medal.
Indeed. Alexei Klimov of the Russian Federation leaves this competition in fourth place, but with the quota place. So we're down to the final three. It's Ki Kompoi of France, Zhang of China, and Lin of China.
The medal amongst the two Chinese athletes here. The next shot decides the bronze medalist.
So this series decides our first medal. at the moment, it's looking like it's probably going to go Ki Kompois' way. I don't think the Chinese now are going to falter, but we will see.
Commentator's curse. It's a real thing.
Je suis désolé. Je parle français un peu. Four hits. 29. What a final this has been, just for different reasons, Christian. I mean, it's...
If you'd said to me beforehand, we're going to see two shooters so far have a shot over time, I'd have said at a World Championships. I mean, no, we're not. But we have, and I don't think I've commentated on a final before where I've had to say, oh, that was one, another one over time.
Yeah, I mean, it might happen once, but...
Yeah.
Ki Kompois only with two hits.
Yeah, that could be something as simple as they're coming into this, they're thinking, first opportunity for quota places, World Championships, a little bit more nervous than normal. We'll try not to rush the series. We'll try and go slowly, make it controlled, and they've just slowed it too much. They've just put the brakes down a little bit too much, and it's then 10th, 100th of a second over, boom, hit deduction.
Attention.
And in the case of Ollie, then goodbye to everything.
So Zhang's done it. He's still in. Scores four, like his fellow countryman Lin. It means the two Chinese remain. Ki Kompois of France has a bronze medal.
And with a quota place for France.
And also a quota place for Tokyo 2012. There he is, Jean Ki Kompois. Looks relieved. He's big sigh of relief. Thankfully, it's all done and dusted, and a bronze medal is going back to France. That adds to his many medals at the World Championship gold as a junior in 2014, the silver medal at the Rio Olympics as well for Jean Ki Kompois. He has two World Cup gold medals, two silvers and two bronze, and now he has a World Championship bronze.
And that really is a testament to his, you know, abilities. You said he won as a junior 4 years ago. In 4 years, he's transitioned to senior and is already best in the world.
This is what I mean. This is what I keep saying. I've just read out all those medals, and they're just, you know, some of the silvers and golds. I haven't touched on the bronzes yet. He's just got a bronze medal there. The guy's 22. Incredible.
Attention. Yeah.
I do love the way Lin just raises that pistol and goes for it. It's absolutely brilliant. Scores three.
Down.
This could be Zhang's.
32 hits is not a bad score by any means. I mean, the old record was 34, I think, the old world record, something like that. It's not a... Eight hits dropped is not a disaster by any means for him.
It seems more. It feels more, doesn't it? Having watched the final, it feels like they've only hit about 25.
Every now and then somebody gets a hit.
You know. Right, here we go. Three! Oh. Who'd have thought they'd matched each other just again? But what it does mean is that we do have a gold medalist and we do have a world champion. The world number one is still the world number one. He is the world champion. It's another gold medal going to China. Lin Jumin has done it. China are top of the medal tables, which you wouldn't be surprised with. They took the lead over the last couple of days. They now are on 12 gold medals. That being the 12th. The silver medal is going to Zhang of China, who finished on a total of 31, and Jean Ki Kompois of France being announced now. There he is, the bronze medalist. Looks happy. The silver medalist will now be announced officially, representing the People's Republic of China. Zhang Jun, there he is, takes a bow. Thank you very much. And Lin Junmin, the world number one, and is still the world number one. He is now the world champion. Cool as ice, there he is, the world champion. 21 years old.
The youngest athlete out there today.
Incredible. So there we go. That concludes the 25-metre rapid fire pistol men's final. If you would like to watch this back, you're more than welcome to do so on YouTube. You can also search for the hashtag ISSF. You'll find us also on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. And if you want some Chinese content and some interviews with the Chinese athletes, go to Weibo and Youku for the latest there. That's all from us. The next final is at 4 o'clock, the junior 25-metre rapid fire final. It'll be me, Rory McAllister, back for that. So until then, we'll see you in about an hour's time from me and everyone here at ISSF TV and from Christian Callahan of Great Britain. Thank you very, very much for joining us. We bid you farewell and we'll see you in just under an hour's time. Goodbye. The bronze medal representing France goes to Jean Quiquempois. Silver medal representing the People's Republic of China goes to Yang Zhang. And the gold medal representing the People's Republic of China goes to Lin Jumin. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of the People's Republic of China.
모두 자리에서 일어서 주십시오. 중국의 국가 연주가 있겠습니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, we congratulate the winners of the 25m rapid fire pistol men event.
네, 25m 속사포원총 남자 종목의 메달 수상자들입니다.
We will now take some photographs of the medal winners.